Hi everybody, it's your girl Bunny. We have 3 episodes left, 8, 9, and 10. How have you been enjoying the recap so far? I hope that you like the series as well on Netflix. So here we go. It's Netflix, the original series, The Dark Crystal, Age of Resistance. Season 1, Episode 8, Prophets Don't Know Everything. It's coming up next. It's Bunny. So we have Olga. She meets with Celadon and she sees that Celadon is dressed different. She has the all black and she's even beat with the black eyeshadow. She looks completely different. And she notices the rage and she notices the anger in Celadon. And Celadon expresses to Olga, we have a lot of traitors in Thra. We need to understand that all of the respect goes to the Skeksis. And of course, Olga is trying to tell her, you must understand the truth. Tradition and what you thought things were or how they have been is a lie. You have to engage in the truth. You are filled with anger, rage towards your family, and you need to stop and see the truth. And Celadon's not having it. She is so in a rush, and she is so consistent with her belief, and she is in her hurry to get back to the Skeksis because she is loyal. And she wants to show them all of the work that she's been doing and not only making sure that people are believing the lies or the mistruths about her mother, but also her sister as well. So she heads to that area. And before she does, Olga doesn't want to go to that area because she knows it's very dangerous. So Olga pops out her remaining eye and slips it into the bag of Celadon so she can literally keep an eye on her to see what the status is once she gets there with the Skeksis. And Olga, she sits there by her tree and she meditates and she focuses so she can see with that eye in Celadon's bag. Rian and Deet, they're on their way to Grot because remember, their mission is to get the double-edged dual sword, and that sword will help them defeat the Skeksis. And as they're going, Deet is describing her homeland, her life underground, and is telling him, we must flow with the breath of Thra, the wind that will take us through the tunnels and underneath the ground to guide us where we need to go. Because I have an idea of maybe where this sword is located. So they take a journey and she tells him to hold on because of course Deet has wings and she's going through all of the tunnels underground, heading to Grot and going deeper into Grot. And Rian is saying, how can you see? It's so dark. And he's forgetting he's been above ground and Deet has no issue with that because she's been underground her whole life and that's why she has the big eyes and she can see. And she says, use all of your senses to see here and don't worry, I'll help you and guide you along while we're in Grot and underground. We still have the Skeksis. They've collected all of these Gelfling and they are placing them in front of the crystal to continue to pull all of the essence from them. And all of the other Gelfling that are in captivity in their cages, they watch and they hear all of these negative things happening. Meanwhile, the crystal is getting darker and darker and more damage to the crystal is happening. Rian and Deet, they arrive to where she's from and they see that there's no one there. There's hardly anybody there. It's very quiet. And Rian says, where is everyone? And Deet says, I think they've all been captured. And I don't know where they've gone, but I can make a good guess that they've all been captured. But I need to go back to my house just in case some family members are there. We need to try to search for them. Remaining people that are there, they see that they have that bug that is connected in their ear to their brains, controlling them and their every movement, and they're being led outside of the tunnels to, of course, make that journey back to the Skeksis. Celadon, she eventually arrives to the Skeksis castle, and when she gets there, she's puffed up with her ego, completely blinded and unaware of the truth that everybody has been telling her. And when she gets there, she tells the Skeksis, "I've done a great job in making sure that we capture all of the traitors, and I just want you to know that I'll continue to do that and serve you all for the protection of the crystal." And they laugh, and they begin to laugh at her, and she seems confused about why they're laughing. And they say, "Oh yes, you've been very loyal in making sure that you bring us all of the Gefling here so we can capture all of their essence. Yes, 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 bring me more. You have been so loyal in our request in order to get all of the Gefling. They have been very delicious." And Celadon suddenly, finally has that epiphany that what everybody was trying to tell her was the truth. And she says, "Well, because I've been so loyal, do you think you can spare me and the rest of the Gelfling that are in captivity and in the cages?" And the Emperor says, "Well, no." And they laugh and they just soak in their triumph in her being an idiot, pretty much, and not looking at the truth. And they proceed to grab her and lock her up as well. So she finally sees the truth. She finally sees all of the Gelfling locked up. And she realizes that what everybody was trying to tell her was the truth. And she is absolutely defeated in the way that she's been behaving. And she starts to cry. And she starts to reflect and think about her mother. She starts to reflect and think about Brea and everybody that was around her that tried to show her the truth. But she was filled with so much anger and sadness, she couldn't see it. Deke goes back to her home only to find it completely demolished and destroyed, and she's very sad that her family was taken. And the only thing that she sees that is left is her brother. And her brother's in the corner kind of hunched over. So she thinks that he hasn't been affected yet by the bugs that have the mind control. And she tries to reach out to talk to him and hug him, but he turns around, and unfortunately, he has been captured as well. And he looks like he's to the point of no return, and Deet and Rion, they know that they must get away from him, because if they're too close to him, he can start to alert the other spider creatures or maybe other bugs to let them know that the other Gelfling are here and that they can capture them. We have the hunter. He returns back to the Skeksis castle, but he is full of arrows from the archer, and he completely passes out. The scientist says he's passed out and he's not dead, but they're like, "Well, let's prop him up, because he is the hunter and he needs respect, because to them, the hunter is very strong, and to see him so weak wasn't something they could really compute." So they said, "Well, let's make sure that we prop him up so he can heal, just to see if we can make him better. But he can't be dead. He can't be dead." And Rion, they're trying to escape from Deet's brother. And as they're trying to escape, her brother grabs her leg and says, "Down here, follow me." And it's like, okay. Of course, with the hunter arriving, he had Brea, and Brea is put into captivity with everybody else, and of course Celadon is with her as well. And Brea says, "Celadon, do you now see the truth? Do you now see what they're doing to Gelfling? Do you now see that they're capturing their essence, and they don't care for you, and there's no such thing as loyalty to them?" And Celadon says, "If Mother would have just compromised with the Skeksis and not tried to go against them, then maybe we wouldn't have been in this. And maybe if you didn't do this, we could have done that. And she still is placing the blame on everyone else. And she makes the argument that the Sketsies are powerful and what they could have done is compromise. And Brea says, no, if we would have done that, they still would have captured us. Their main focus is to capture our essence. Why can't you see the truth? So Deet and Rion, and of course the brother, they go to an area where we have, I think they're called the Ascendants. The spider creatures collectively are called the Ascendants. And Deet says, well, what do you want from us? And why are you helping the Sketsies? They're evil and they're taking advantage of you. They took advantage of us in getting energy from the crystal and taking our essence. They're only going to do you wrong in the end as well. So the spider creatures communicate that, well, we want our original home back. This was taken from us, and the Sketsies have told us that they will give us back our home if we are allies with them. And Deet says, I never knew that this was your main homeland. I've grown up here. I've had family members that have grown up here. We are very peaceful people. And you have to see the truth that the Sketsies are not here to help you. They are using you. They are, as you can tell with our people, they're hurting us. And in the end, believe me, they will hurt you as well. And it's very unlikely that they will grant this land to you. Why don't you allow me to speak with my people? And my people, of course, will have no problem with you living here as well, because there are other creatures that are here and we live in harmony. And the ascendants think that this makes a lot of sense, so they agree to help Deet. Rion tells Deet, go on without me, because I have to find this dual sword. It's very important if we plan on having any type of resistance or any type of rebellion against the Sketsies. So you must journey back in that direction. Before they can leave, the Century Tree is dying, and it is to the point of no return. And the Century Tree explains that it is consumed with darkness, and it touches Deet and communicates with Deet. And as she does that, it continues to die, but it wants to transfer its wisdom with her and information with her. And at the same time that is happening, unfortunately, Deet consumes the darkness as well. After she does so, she has the wisdom and she has the information from the Century Tree. Unfortunately, the Century Tree dies. There's just too much darkness. But she has the wisdom, and you could see little streams of purple in her hands and a little bit on her face. So we see that Deet has consumed darkness. The wisdom that the Century Tree gives Deet is foresight and other skills that she may need in the future. So that was the end of the episode. Let me know what you think. It was very sad to see a lot of the Gelfling be in captivity and a lot of them being used for the essence. But we're almost done, you guys, with the series. Only 2 episodes left to quickly recap. Let me know what you think. Subscribe, hit that notification bell so you don't miss any posts. And follow me on Instagram, same profile name, officialbun_E. Bye. See you for episode 9.